The Lord is a God who the Bible tells us in Isaiah 59 verse 2 doesn't have an ear that's deaf that he cannot hear, and his arm is not shortened that he cannot save. Mm-hmm. And you know, God really hears and answers our prayers. This first story from my childhood is actually the first memory I ever had. It was when I was 3.5 years old, and every night before we went to sleep, my parents and I would kneel and we would pray together. Mm. We'd ask for the Lord's blessing, for his protection through the night. And little did my parents realize, I think, that night what a necessity that prayer was and what an answer to prayer God would send. I grew up in Northern California in a little town called Angwin. It's home of Pacific Union College.
That's right, yeah.
Top of a mountain in the Napa Valley. And there where I grew up in that house was at the bottom of a hill. And there was a decent amount of forest behind it, some evergreens and a couple of large oak trees. And it had been raining for almost 4 days straight, in the middle of this winter. And my dad had seen, as he was walking with the neighbor, this tree that was leaning toward our house. It was an oak tree. Mm-hmm. The neighbor mentioned to him, they said, you know, you should probably look at cutting that down. And he said, yeah, I should. So he went up and he looked at it. On the outside, the tree looked good and healthy. And he got some advice from someone else. And they said, yeah, the tree is fine. No problem with it. But that night at about 2:30 in the morning, there was this loud crash. Mm. My dad just immediately panicked. He jumped up. He ran to my room because that's where this shaking the entire house had come from. And when he opened the door, there were branches facing him. And he ducked under the branches. He turned around and he looked at my bed. And now I'll hit the pause button and tell you what I remember. I remember being asleep on my left side, and the wall was behind me, and I was facing out into my room. And I started to wake up, but I felt something warm on the top of my head, almost like when your head is close to a light bulb. Mm-hmm. And I felt like my covers were slowly being pulled up over me. And I was just so comfortable, I just went back to sleep, didn't even open my eyes. Well, when my dad looked at my bed, he saw that the pillow where my head had been had two branches stabbing it. Oh. And there I was, all the way at the foot of my bed with the blankets completely untouched. And I was under the blankets still asleep.